You may remember that I have talked about Da Boom Crew before. I put it as number 2 on my top 10 worst cartoons of the 2000s. Let me put that in perspective. Da Boom Crew is one of the worst cartoons of one of the worst decades in animation history. To describe the show, it is one of the most offensive, worthless pieces of shit that I have ever seen. It is in the top 10 worst cartoons that I have ever seen. Episode upon episode of this trash I've tried to watch. It's filled with blatant ripoffs, blatant pandering, and most of all, blatant stereotypes and possibly racism for kids. Buckle up, because this is a wild ride with no way off, and I'm not too happy about this one. The first few frames of the show do make it look promising. There's a kid in space firing a laser at a monster while he calls his brother to help him find a game cartridge. Unfortunately, we're about to go downhill really fucking fast.
Don't trip, Justin. I'm all over this boom cart.
And here, we have the first major problem with the series. Our main characters talk in the most annoying, obnoxious slang that you will ever hear. It's obviously outdated now, but was it outdated back in the 2000s when the show came out? I mean, that was 10 years ago.
Gnarly halfpipe.
Well, that slang dates to about 1995, maybe 1985, 10 to 20 years before Da Boom Crew came out.
Tony Hawk it later, homie!
Yeah, remember back in the early 2000s when you and all your homies were Tony Hawking it all up over the splees? No, because that never happened, because no one used any of this slang ever. Tony Hawk was never used as a verb in slang. The writers just jumbled together a bunch of words they thought sounded cool to pander to kids. And, there are many, many unfortunate implications about this. It's great that you're trying to have a diverse cast, but when every character talks like an obnoxious stereotype, it doesn't reflect very well on you. So two of the main characters are black characters, and they're both token black characters, despite being the main characters of the show. I swear, these characters are written like the people behind the show have never seen a black person before, and have only heard about them in legends and fairy tales. How do you fuck up this badly? Do you mean, can't touch this? Hammerman still pops with the kids, right? He's gotta be tops. I'm sure, dropping it down with them groovy beats.
Dude, your faking McTwist needs some serious practice.
Seriously, can I get the subtitled version of this episode? You know, the one that hints the characters might be spouting dialogue that is understandable somewhere on Earth.
Ricky, what's up with the net?
Time-release proportional laser restraint grid should be operational any moment.
What?
The net.
The one character who doesn't speak in incomprehensible slang talks in technobabble that they indeed had to make up themselves. This is supposed to be a running gag where she calls these common household tools like a wrench or a hammer these made-up sci-fi words. And it's tied into her character. You see, she's a token too. She's the token nerd. Because none of these characters have any goddamn personality. These two characters here are written and act almost exactly the same on the show. Which, once again, can be taken the wrong way very fast. Also, does this look familiar to you? Yeah, this show tries his damnedest to rip off Samurai Jack. Samurai Jack, if you don't know, is my favorite cartoon of all time. So you might imagine that I'd be pretty pissed off to see it badly stolen and placed here. Hey, this is popular with the kids. Let's blatantly steal stuff, and then maybe we'll be the most popular cartoon of all time. How'd that turn out for you guys? Yeah, a show with hefty unfortunate implications and does nothing but pander. Can you imagine a show like that making it big? Huh, maybe Da Boom Crew was just too ahead of its time. But back on topic, the concept of Samurai Jack is that an evil sorcerer sends the only person who could possibly defeat him, with the only weapon that could possibly defeat him, thousands of years into the future so he can get powerful enough to stop the samurai. Here's the concept of Da Boom Crew, you're gonna love it. Four kids design and build a video game. Then one day, because blaga fraga dada, they're teleported into a world that's identical to their game. And yet, they're constantly surprised by everything, and they don't know where anything is. Let me repeat that for those who have brain function that reasonably states that this is too stupid for anyone to reasonably consider. These characters are in a world that looks exactly like a video game that they built. It was described as identical to a video game that they built. But they do not know where anything is, and they're constantly surprised by everything they come across. If I got pulled into a video game that I made, well, to be honest, I'd probably kill myself to get it over with as quickly as possible, but at least I know where all the goddamn secrets are. I don't think I've ever come across something like this before. The concepts of this show is a plot hole. Someone, somewhere, had to stop and think about this, right? Oh, who am I kidding? Kids are stupid. They'll watch anything as long as we got lots of pandering and we steal things from everything. Your theme song stole the music from Puff Daddy's Come With Me. We are 4 minutes in, at the intro. And this show is one of the shows that I respect the least. I respect it less than almost everything else that I've come across. Ren Seeks Help had more effort, at least. Hell, Over Two Rainbows at least tried to do something original. I mean it. Over Two Rainbows put a ton of effort into doing as little as possible. Da Boom Crew put as much effort into stealing other things because it's creatively sterile and stupid. And it has just as low of an opinion of its target audience as Over Two Rainbows. When these boom cartridges are inserted into a thing, it makes the bad guys go away and restores the planet to its natural state. Savvy? Good. Let's talk about the bad guy. He apparently wants all of this chaos, and yet his robot wasn't destroyed by them inserting the cartridge into their thing. It goes to the shelled out remains of the Death Star because original designs? Nah, those cost money and effort, and might give the inkling that we actually fucking care about what we're doing! Then we get introduced to this show's version of Darth Vader. He's,
Zorchi, baby! What's crackin'? You know my associate, Jerome? Don't worry, I've been making some upgrades. My next crew of bot baddies will be—
Your Exki, I need those kids out of the way, and I need those energy discs.
Why the kids are in the galaxy that they coded, yet don't understand anything about, is never explained. Just one day a space thing happens and puts them into space for no reason whatsoever, and it looks like the space that they coded.
You got it all. Fame, fortune, evil tyranny? What more could a brother want?
What I want is to extinguish all light from the universe.
You know, you don't really have to do anything then, right? It'll happen like in trillions of years as the stars go out and essentially explode, leaving the universe in natural darkness forever. I'm sad now. So Darth Dipshit decides that he wants the boom discs for himself. And then we go back to...
Yeah! Kickflip 360!
Shut up! Shut the fuck up! If you wanted to make a show about incomprehensible skateboarding slang, Rocket Power beat you about 5 years. I keep complaining about his lingo because every line of his dialogue is pain to my ears and my psyche, but I want this review to be under a century long. Let me leave it at this. His entire character in this episode is skateboards. Skateboards, skateboards, skateboards. His brain is a fucking skateboard. Now our characters have some downtime. A competent pilot would use this time to establish more character traits in our main characters, things that we haven't seen before. If you want your show to last a long time, you need to make your characters as strong as possible. You're probably not going to make them multi-dimensional in the first episode, but it's good to get as much as possible. Here's what the Boom Crew does. This kid does exactly what he was doing before. This kid does exactly what he was doing before. This kid does literally nothing. And this kid does exactly what she was doing before. You have 22 fucking minutes, and I know less about your main characters than the background characters and other shows that have 7-minute episodes.
As soon as I bring the Astro Navigator back online, I'll figure out where the heck we are. But I'm going to require an interfaceable corrective implement. Stat. A wrench, you lug nuts!
Okay, why the technobabble? I'm not a handyman, an inventor, or a scientist, so maybe I just don't understand this. Why would you give simple tools the most complicated descriptions possible of your own device, of your own invention, when you're around other people who have no hope of understanding you, and you need their assistance? I get the intention that this is to make her seem smart. What this actually does is make her seem incredibly stupid to common sense. They figure out where another boom card is, and they need a computer despite the fact that they made the fucking game. I got inkling you're tooting the wrong ringer, man. I'm not certain the deals is in your visage. Know what I'm saying? Of course you don't know what I'm saying, because slang in animation is stupid! It takes about 6 months to a year to make an episode of television quality animation or Family Guy, and slang moves faster than that. A word of slang will be dead in about 5 weeks. Unless you want to make your show as cheap as 12-ounce mouse, any slang you use should be assumed to be out of date by default. So the kids land on a planet.
What is this?
You tell me! You designed the fucking game! The inventor kid says it's a fruit tree, but it has a Yeti thing inside of it for no apparent reason. You know, it just occurred to me. I'd much rather be watching Samurai Jack than this piece of shit. So after a fight scene, some guy runs up to the Boom Crew. And if you could believe it, if it's possible, the show just got more offensive. First of all, the space alien, who lives in outer space, talks with a French accent.
Aha! Get back! I'm running you, mutant tree scum!
Vegetarian. But a sensible lifestyle decision.
A bad stereotypical one that he frequently slips out of. Also, he's a coward. He's afraid of everything. Every second of this show is uncomfortable in ways that I haven't experienced before this day. I have a feeling that this was like an accident or something. Like, the creators didn't know any better because they show no awareness that this kind of portrayal is a bad thing. Just like they show no awareness that their tokenism and obnoxious slang is a bad thing either. At best, The Cowardly Frenchman is a painfully outdated joke that's been seen way too much and makes the show even more questionable. At worst, how the hell did anyone sit down, watch this, and think that any part of this episode was okay? This alien says that he knows where another one of the boom carts are.
How long have you been here?
You tell me, you designed the fucking game! Oh wait, they designed the game. So they were the ones who decided the cowardly space alien afraid of everything was French. I really don't like these characters. So we learn a backstory. The bad guy did bad guy things to this guy and screwed up his life. It's like a trying to be funny version of a heartwarming backstory from Samurai Jack. And as a result, we have a piece of shit that isn't funny or heartwarming.
If you were fighting so bravely, how come this painting shows you running like a scared little girl?
You tell me. You designed the game.
We created our own video game where we play heroes battling outer space villains. But one day we were sucked up by a supernatural vortex and dropped into a world identical to our game.
Do you know what design a game means? Do you know what it means to create a game? It means that you determine what is in the game. It means that you determine how the game works. And you know what? Actually, do tell me. Why would the space alien, afraid of everything and trying to lie about his heroism, draw a cave portrait of him running away? I'm beginning to think you guys are shitty game designers. I mean, take a look at another show with a similar concept, Code Lyoko. They get surprised by things in the game, but that's because they found it. They didn't make it themselves. The space alien says that all of his worst fears are coming to life because of the boom cartridge. Also, for some reason, the boom crew is splashed around the episode on various backgrounds. I have no idea why. I mean, I get it, it's the title of the show, and the boom crew technically made the game, I think. But it's just distracting. If it's meant to be something like the snail in Adventure Time, that's pretty much always kept out of the way, and you really need to go out of your way to find it, and it fits with the environment. Then they all get attacked by a monster. Okay, well, that wasn't very well animated. And for some reason, the girl doesn't even use her weapon.
I knew I should've got the extended warranty.
Get it? Because it's a weapon that only exists in a video game, and there are no warranties for video game weapons, and as far as I can tell, he never actually purchased it, and this joke doesn't make any sort of sense in any universe. The fight ends when the boom crew member, who has the least personality of all of them, tosses some jerky aside and distracts the monsters. Pretty much all he does in the episode, really. This convinces the space alien to take them to the boom cart. Meanwhile, Darth Derp is flying around the universe. He also has a band in his spaceship, in a joke that I really don't understand.
There's nothing good on this radio. Jerome, handle my villainous mood. Yes, now I'm feeling evil.
Really, all I'm feeling is annoyed. Seriously, this music is stupid and annoying and it goes on and on. And the worst part is that it's loud enough to start drowning out the audio of the dialogue.
Let me see if I've got this right. You're from a planet called Earth, and you made a homemade video game that went boom.
That's why they call us the Boom Crew.
Who? Who calls you the Boom Crew? As far as I can tell, the only people who call you the Boom Crew are you yourselves. I mean, if you're stealing from Samurai Jack, again, people actually called Jack Jack before he called himself Jack. Get it, Jack?
And flung you into this parallel universe that's a lot like your game.
Word. Except now, it's for real.
And you have to retrieve the missing boom cats in order to restore harmony to this galaxy.
Uh-huh.
And you think I'm crazy?
Oh my god! Pointing out your problems does not make them go away. Kids being pulled into a video game or technology for whatever reason is a great concept. A lot of good cartoons have gotten a lot of good mileage out of such a concept. But the Boom Crew, there is no way to do this concept worse than the way you have done it. The concept of your show is actively going against everything that the show is trying to do. This world is a lot like your game. The space alien knows this. He has admitted this. Why the hell do you need help finding the boom cartridge? You designed the game. You should know where it is. Where all of them are without any help whatsoever. None of you have amnesia. Even if this game was procedurally generated, you should at least be aware of what you could experience. This space alien is analogous to an NPC with coding that one of you at one point would have had to put in. How did no one realize how stupid this sounded? The plot of the show is literally a plot hole. It's not that they didn't think it through, it's that they didn't think about it at all. And speaking of absolute stupidity, knowing that everything the space alien is afraid of comes to life One of the kids asks him everything that he's afraid of. We have another fight scene. Maybe it's just because the show is awful, but I'm really getting bored of all the fight scenes. I don't care about these kids or their objective or the show, and those are important things to keep fight scenes interesting. I mean, for all you've stolen from Samurai Jack, you would at least bother to do that. I get the idea. Kids are supposed to see themselves in these characters' shoes. That's why their characterization is so weak. They're supposed to be self-inserts. It's just...
You know, Blurp, when I barreled into my first tube, the wave was so aggro I wanted to bail. But I cowboyed up and shot the pocket.
No, just no. One of the kids finds the boom cart, but then Darth Dipwad gets to it first. And before he gets away, the space alien starts charging towards them with all of his fears. Hey, Darth Dumbass! Your rocket is right there. You've got a million robots. Why don't you just have them distract the boom crew and leave? Instead, they just stand there trying to push it back and forth with each other. So how does putting duct tape on the guy with the helmet stop him from speaking? I know that a lot of other cartoons also pull this stunt. I don't care. The worse the show is, the more minor problems you end up seeing, and the less likely you are to forgive them. You see, if the boom crew was good, I wouldn't care about this. But because the show is foul and disease-ridden, even minor problems telegraph themselves to you like a neon sign.
Just as I suspected. This runaway boom cart was causing all of Blurp's fears to become real.
What do you mean that you suspected? It was already outright stated.
Those kids will not stand in my way much longer.
You're right, because your show is canceled 4 episodes in.
Creatures will be set free and the galaxy will be mine.
Oh my god, how could you fuck up lip syncing that badly? You could have 2 frames, one for open mouth and one for closed mouth, and it would still look better than what you just did. And then we ended on a Star Wars homage, because can't have anything original. Nope, nope, nope. This was a tough one. I had an easier time reviewing Kingstar King. I'm not even kidding. Every second of the show pushes your patience. It's not gross, but it's the most obnoxious thing I've ever watched. 90% of the time, you can't understand what anyone is saying. The plot, down to the very concept, is plot holes. And every second, it seems to be ripping off something from a new source material. Not to mention the stereotypes make this more than uncomfortable in its own right. I'm going home because I don't give a shit anymore. Happy Easter.
Thing you do. I know that I can always be myself. You must-